Okay, I'm attempting to show how to skin and flesh beaver tail. And I've already discovered by doing a couple of these that I just got in the mail that it's a whole lot easier to do beaver tails on a fresh beaver that you just skin. Some of these are already drying out. Some of them are losing scales from sitting around. This one actually, it seems like it's a little smelly. So, you know, if at all possible, do them as quickly as possible. As quickly as you can, and don't leave them sitting around, because you're just making more trouble for yourself and you're going to screw them up. Screw some of them up. Normally, that's about as far as I would have to go, and I think this one might feel alright. It's not a huge one. I'm just working it down without, you know, I'll cut into the tail part, I mean the skin part of the tail. Leave some bristle on there, that's fine. You'll take that off. Yeah, this definitely has a smell to it already. Good thing I'm used to strong smell. I mean, this isn't nasty. Too bad. But just spoiled a little bit. I'll flip it over and I'll do some of this side too. When it's on the beaver, you know, you just leave it on the beaver and do all this. You have a lot more leverage to pull it off. And a lot of people, you know, if it's already off, they'll put it in a vise or whatever. I don't have a vise here. I'm going to have to try to do it without it. We'll see how it goes. I think a little longer knife like this is better than a short one. Yeah, this tail isn't very big, but still for the fleshing part, it definitely gets better with a longer knife. This is a boning knife. Unless we use a flaying knife. Let's see what this is going to do. I just hooked onto it with big pair of pliers. I'm going to go on it. Take it down a little farther. It's kind of sticking here in the middle. Like I said, it's amazing how much easier a fresh tail will go. Just peel right off there like nothing. Yeah, it's coming off. Rather than the hole, we'll see. You don't want to jerk on it. You want to just keep slow, gradual. Yeah, it peels right to the tip on that one. That's the way it's supposed to work. Now this side, you always have a lot more stuff left on. Okay, now we'll try to, I might rearrange my camera just a little bit. I'm going to flesh this stuff off. And it's kind of like fleshing or flaying a fish. Again, this is broken down just a little bit. Coming off all right, but not quite as easy as it would fresh. And of course, you want to be real careful because you can easily slice the tail. But when you play a fish, you flip it back over and take the skin off. It's the same concept. Except I'm not trying to get, I'm not worried about getting a whole fillet off at once. Just get it off anywhere I can. Get as much of it as I can. A lot of times it's easy to work from the center out if you have a little in that little spot right there along the edge. cut that off. This one's still got the scales and everything on it, so I can do it with the scales on, or I can take them off and do bark tanning. Some of these scales were already slipping. Just from them. Yeah, I made a little screw up there. There you go. I show my screw ups and everything. That one's done.